My name is Lucky Khambule. I'm from South Africa by birth. I've been in Ireland for the past almost 6 years now. I live in direct provision. I was in Cork. This group called Masi, it's a movement of asylum seekers in Ireland. It's a group that was formed by asylum seekers for the asylum seekers to find our own voice as asylum seekers. It's important that you know and understand that with Masi, you will never go wrong as an asylum seeker. We organize ourselves. We've got supporters working hard to push us. We'll see the pain that we go through as we are in direct provision. As you all know, direct provision has been existent for the past 18 years now. All these times, these years, no one was allowed to work. The legislation didn't allow anyone to work. We are here today because we feel the fact that if we were allowed to work, all of us, we won't be staying in that direct provision. It's a pillar that is meant to hold direct provision because they get money out of it. 35 euros is paid for that bed that you use, for that bunk bed that you use, for each person in direct provision. So we want to say, even though the right to work has been given, or so they say, we are still saying as Masi, we don't have the right to work. We don't have the right. Until such time, everybody who comes in this country has and avail himself or herself of protection, has undiscriminative right to work immediately, so that people can be able to support themselves and not be abandoned to the state. That's all what we want. We don't want this 6 months permit. We don't want this first instance refusal definition, which categorizes us that if you have been here and you have been refused and you stop being a human being because you have been refused. That's what the minister says. But we are saying, even if you have been refused because you would have been failed by the system, we want the minister to acknowledge and give you the right to work. We want people not to be deported here. Deportations is a killer. If there's anyone that is here, I don't want you to even show your hand. If there's anyone that is here who is under deportation order, please know that you are not alone. We are with you. We will stand by you until the end. We will fight with you to make sure that you stay in this country.